everyone. My name is Hilary Kennedy, and I'm the Program Director for Medicaid Leadership at NAMD, joined once again by my colleague, Ed O'Neill. We are here as part of our Quick Take series, as part of the Medicaid Leadership Exchange podcast, which launched with an earlier episode on developing others. Today's conversation will focus on effective delegation in a period of time when we are all working remotely and have some new challenges that are part of this COVID pandemic. Ed's going to share a couple of key strategies and insights, and then we'll find more detail in our accompanying tip sheet two-pager that will be released with this podcast. So, Ed, I'll turn it to you.
Great. Thanks, Hilary. It's great to be back with everyone. This topic today, delegation, effective delegation, is really a sister companion piece with development. They're intimately connected, and I'll try to unfold a little bit of that to try to drive your attention to it. I don't know any really effective leader that's not a good delegator, but every leader can always be better at delegation. We all have something crazy in the back of our head. They're too busy. I don't have anyone to do it. It won't be done as well as if I do it. There's not enough time for me to teach somebody else. And even some darker reasons for not delegating. What will I do if they do all the delegations outstandingly well? Well, you want to push through that and get to delegation, because really when you're not delegating effectively, then you're not doing the things that you need to be doing as a leader. First, area to pay attention to with delegation is development. If you're delegating without a development plan by your colleague, then it's going to be twice as hard and not nearly as deep. But if you've got a development plan and you can delegate to that development plan, then each time you offer a stretch activity for them, they see how valuable it is for them to learn and grow. It doesn't mean that everything that you delegate has to be a stretch activity, but it has to be anchored in that. So if you haven't done a development plan, now's the time to do one. And take a look at that first little link back to development planning. Second, and this is really a challenge in Zoom world, particularly if it's somebody that you're delegating to that you haven't worked with, is to know you and to know them. So you need to get comfortable with your style, their style, and you're responsible as a leader for getting those to be in sync. I know we sometimes think it's their job, but it really is ours. So particularly around things like communication, how much, when, structure, media, all those things need to be recast, even for someone that you've been delegating to for a while. This is a different environment. We need to take them into consideration. Second is structure. Are we delegating for a task? Are we delegating responsibilities? Is it long-term, short-term, all of those? And then I think just out front, dealing with freedom. How much freedom are you comfortable with? How much can you allow? How much do they want? How much will they thrive? People may be a little more buttoned down in this world until they fully understand the range of what they can do. You want to define their work specifically, extensively, maybe a little bit more than you would when you could just do some check-ins around the office. But be careful about that they get all the details that they need. And this is a time where if you're maybe a little bit more on the micromanaging side, it'll be fine until you work that out. I'd rather see an error made in that direction than in not enough details. You also need to ask for what you need, defining your role, the context, everything that you're going to need to keep you from being crazy. That's one of the things that's really important in leadership, is that you not be crazy. So if you need to hear more often, just say, it's not what I usually expect. I have not changed my opinion of you, but given this world we're in, I need to hear just a little bit more frequently from you. And then don't forget that a part of delegation and development together is that each delegation should have some time called out to teach. Just a little bit. What'd you learn? What problems did you have? What resources did you use? What would you do differently next time? 5-10 minutes. People are getting tired of hearing about your dog and cat and looking at the artwork that your children are doing behind you. So give them a break and focus back on them and teach a little bit out of that delegation once it's been successful. Hilary, I'm going to turn it back to you. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Ed. I'd like to think that nobody is getting sick of seeing my dog, but maybe that is not the case in these Zoom calls. So as Ed said, this is the second in a series that we've been putting together in partnership with the Center for Healthcare Strategies, with support from the Robert Wood Johnson Foundation It's part of our Medicaid Leadership Exchange podcast series, and we hope that you find the accompanying tip sheet and quick takes document that Ed has put together full of additional details as you work to successfully delegate from a distance. Thanks, everyone.